आय एम आमिर मुस्तफा शेख, वर्किंग ॲज असिस्टंट प्रोफेसर इन मेकॅनिकल इंजिनिअरिंग डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ रयत शिक्षण संस्थाज कर्मवीर भारवा पाटील कॉलेज ऑफ इंजिनिअरिंग सातारा. दिस इज ॲक्टिव्हिटी रिलेटेड टू इंटरनॅशनल FDP ऑन एन्व्हायरमेंट अँड सस्टेनेबिलिटी. वीक वन, व्हिडिओ डिटेल्स, इफेक्ट ऑफ पोल्युटंट्स, इमिशन, सोर्सेस ऑफ पोल्युटंट्स, मेथड्स फॉर SI इंजिन इमिशन कंट्रोल वेअर डिस्कस्ड. वीक टू, व्हिडिओ डिटेल्स, इफेक्ट ऑफ इमिशन, एअर पोल्युशन, फॉर्मेशन ऑफ पोल्युटंट्स, इमिशन रेग्युलेशन अँड केस स्टडी वेअर डिस्कस्ड. Video outcome, examine the content of product of combustion, develop procedure to minimize emission, design of combustion chamber and effect of air fuel mixture, investigate ways and steps to reduce pollution, perform trial or experimentation on IC engine, compare the pollutants of petrol and diesel engine. For week 3 and 4 video, estimation of CO2 emissions of internal combustion were discussed. Table 1 indicate the emission control norms. US EPA specifically an independent executive agency of the United States Federal Government of Environmental Protection. European Emission Standard implemented in Europe. Bharat Stage Emission Standard, Government of India to regulate output of air pollution from SI and CI engine. Table indicate the emission norms and year of implementation for India. Indian 2000 standard references Euro 1 implemented in 2000 nationwide. Bharat stage 2 standard references Euro 2 implemented in 2001 for national capital region NCR, that is Delhi, Mumbai, Kolkata, Chennai, and it is implemented for 13 cities like Mumbai, Kolkata, Chennai, Bengaluru, Hyderabad, Ahmedabad, Pune, Surat, Kanpur, Lucknow, Solapur, Jamshedpur in 2003, and in 2005 it is nationwide. Similarly, Bharat Stage 3 reference is Euro 3 implemented 2005, and 2010 is nationwide. Bharat Stage 4 reference is Euro 4 implemented in 2010. Bharat Stage 5 Euro 5 it is to be skipped, and Bharat Stage 6 is implemented in 2020. entire country. This table indicate the year wise percentage of emission from 1992 to 2010. For CO the value is 14 in 1992, for 96 it is 11.20, for 2000 it is 4.5, for 2001 it is 4, 2005 it is 2.5, and for 2010 it is 1. Emission norm for India for heavy duty vehicles greater than 3.5 tons gram per kilowatt hour. Emission regulation as per as our Bharat stage is to be concerned, from BS1 to BS2 the 63 reduction will be there, from BS2 to 3 33 reduction PM, that is particular matter gram per kilowatt, and from BS3 to BS4 80% reduction of particulate matter PM. Carbon emission calculation, here few steps are there. Number one, vehicle production, raw material, extraction material production, vehicle component production and vehicle assembly plays important role to calculate the CO emission. Number two, fuel production, electric power generation, production of fuel for IC engine vehicle, generation of electric power for battery electric vehicles. Number three, vehicle usage, that is fuel combustion in driving internal combustion engine. And number four, maintenance, production of replacement part. Number five, end of life, that is disposal of vehicles once its useful life has expired. These are the steps to calculate the carbon emission. This is method number one in which we can calculate the emission rate. First step is pollutants. There is need to calculate the emission for the PM2.5 particulate matter, PM10 and SOx, NOx and CO individually. Then by using the emission factor we calculate the emission rate, which is equal to fuel consumption rate in multiplied by emission factor. So this is formula to calculate the CO2 emission. For example, here emission factor I have taken from the paper, 2.33 kg CO2 emits per liter. Car average it is as 8 liter per 100 kilometers, so 8 divided by 10 multiplied by 2.33, which is equal to 186.4 gram CO2 emitted per kilometer. Method 2, in which the mass emission of pollutants are calculated by means of the formula MI is equal to V MIX into Q into KH into CI into 10 raised to minus 6 divided by T, where MI is equal to mass, V is equal to volume, QI is equal to density, KH is equal to humidity correction factor, CI is concentration of pollutant, and D is the distance covered in kilometer. Here we have car CO2 emission. For different manufacturers like Maruti Suzuki, Hyundai, Honda, then Ford, Mahindra and Mahindra, Tata Motors, Toyota, Nissan, Renault, etc. Emission for the metropolitan city, here CO2 and CO emission will be there. The graph indicates the maximum CO emission for the Chennai. Then sustainability in IC engine, how to sustainable with in case of the IC engine. For that there is need to control the emission with the help of the different methods like supercharging, treatment of exhaust products of combustion, modification of the fuel like use of alternate fuel, then EGR is one of the technique, then thermal reactor package, catalytic converter package. So with the help of the catalytic converter we can reduce CO and HC also 80 to 90%. Then the life of the by using the catalytic converter it is up to 80,000 kilometer, and by using the thermal reactor life is 1,65,000 kilometer. These are the benefits gained by using the catalytic converter and thermal reactor. The standards related to the internal combustion engine, the internal combustion engine exhaust emission measurements with the help of this standard like ISO 81781, one indicate the part 1, the 2, 3, 5 indicate the part 1. Like the part 1 is a test bed measurement of gaseous and particulate exhaust emission. Part 2 indicate the measurement of gaseous particulate exhaust emission under filled condition. Part 5 indicate for the test fuel like the sustainability and competition standards related to the IC engines. The higher compression ratios 13:1 or more are possible using petrol with careful engine design or by using the fuel with high octane rating such as ethanol, methane gas, natural gas or hydrogen. So here the few alternate fuel I have mentioned like alcohol, low emission will be there for methanol. No sulfur content, so the organic emission will be lower. For ethanol it is less toxic, clean, less corrosive, so efficiency will be increased. For biodiesel it is free from sulfur, hence sulfate emission and particulate reduction will be taken, also reduce the problem of acid rain. Then sustainability in IC engine, here with the help of by using the alternate jet fuel we can reduce the emission carbon dioxide percentage. Like for Jetropa it is a -37%, for rapeseed it is -37%, soybean we reduce 54% CO2 emission, and for palm it is -61%. So these are the references I have taken the data from the different paper. I am very thankful to all organizing committee of the D.Y. Patil College of Engineering, Akurdi. I am very thankful to Dr. Vinay Kulkarni sir, Dr. Vijay Vadai sir, Dr. P. Malti madam and Dr. Ekta Mishra madam. Thank you very much.